Yeah. ulandele khona sizophumele
qinsi lo mprofeti
indlebo naso zonke
mama
masilandele khona sizophumele
qinsi
lo mprofeti indlebo naso zonke
mama
masilandele khona sizophumela
yesilwe
kwaselo
uthumisela ngempela
ubu naso sonke masilandele khona sizophumela
sangala sabezo besho
sangala sabezo besho saze sabona na timbalwe
sabe Amen.
Amen. Hallelujah. Amen.
Hallelujah.
So when you need to me now.
Nabuge musum to Isa.
Ukona ukona.
Ukona ukona.
Ukona ngempela.
Ukona ngempela. Ungulu ngulu.
Kelenye langa.
I'm going to go to the hospital.
Kodwa mina ngimona ufana noJesu
ufana
sathi mina thala
ufana
nami
ufana nami
mama
ufana nami ufana nami
ngibona yena ngomthanda ngidlale
nami ufana nami ufana nami
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Lizo Pitti, and I'm from the University of Fort Hare, and I shall be your master of ceremonies for this auspicious and historical inaugural memorial lecture in honor of the legend Professor Joseph Shabalala. And also significant to this event is the signing of a relationship between the foundation and the university. It is my pleasure to acknowledge your presence here this morning And before we can get started with our program, can we kindly observe the following? Number one, all proceedings of this event will be going live on television. Therefore, we'd adhere to all in attendance to be cautious of that we are enjoying the viewership of South Africans across the length and breadth of this country. And also, we are living in COVID times. This morning, when I saw the news, we discovered that this morning we're waking up with 19,018 infections, which is a serious concern. Therefore, because of that, all proceedings of this event have not to exceed 2 hours. And it is for that reason that time will be managed strictly. Number two, all honored guests should wear their masks throughout this event. Don't cover your mouth only, but your nose too. Guests will only be allowed to take off their masks when they are on this podium for viewership and also for those who may struggle to hear what you are saying when your mouth is covered. Social distancing, let's try the best we can, that it must be adhered to. That's why we have tried that for each table. We don't fill it up to its capacity. We're leaving some space for people to observe social distancing. Cell phones must be switched to silence or to flight mode. Please, as you know, it will be quite embarrassing when you continue to remind people, I am in an event, but why did you not switch it off? Or rather be turned silent. For those that will need the restrooms, you get out, there are ushers and securities at the door that will directly to where the restrooms are. Before we resume our program, while we are seated, can you all observe a moment of silence just for a minute? Can we? Thank you. At this moment, I would like you to join me in acknowledging the presence of the following honored guests and media houses. We are so honored today that the Deputy Chair of the University of Fort Hare Council, Dr. Sipho Sithole, is here in our presence. With your hand raised, can you greet the audience? Thank you very much, Doc. The Vice Chancellor of the University of Fort Hare, Professor Sakela Butlungu, whom we are going to see soon, just for now, can you just raise your hand, Vice Chancellor? The Deputy Vice Chancellor of Institutional Support, Dr. Oscar van Heerden, can you raise your hand where you are? The Deputy Vice Chancellor for Teaching and Learning, Professor Renuka Vital. Mrs. Shabalala is in our midst, the Dean of the Faculty of Social Sciences. Prof, can you raise your hand where you are? Thank you. Mama Shabalala, umama wethu sonke, umama weMambazo, umama womzansi, mama sicela nje isandla sakho, abantu bakubone nasemakhaya. Our guest speaker, Dr. Sipho Sithole. Doc, can you raise your hand? We are going to see him as he will be owning the best of this time today. I must say we are very excited, Vice Chancellor, when we as the organizing committee, we came up with his name and unanimously everybody say, let's make sure we don't care how busy he is. And we are so humbled by your presence, Dr. Sithole. Thank you. The National Arts Council Visual Arts Panel member, who is also ours at the university, Dr. Sipho Sithole, is here. The lady, our jazz maestro and multi-awards winner, Mr. Mduduz Makatini, he's our own. Can you raise your hand, Mr. Makatini? You know, in many places I go to, when I say, Unduduzo Ibrahim, because other people are used at paying to mingle with him. The Ladysmith Black Mambazo Foundation manager, Mr. Kolani Majozi, and a board member present here, and all board members present here, we will also welcome you. Thank you, foundation members that are here, and Mr. Machos. Thank you very much. The multi-awards winners, including 5 Grammy Awards, I'm not mistaken. The legendary Ladysmith Black Mambazo is in the house. Can you all please raise your hands for Mzansi to see that it is not a fluke. Mambazo is at the University of Fort Hare. Yes, of course, at home, the viewers and the listeners, we welcome you all, and we wish to go through with you from the beginning until the end of this program. Now, ladies and gentlemen, can we all put our hands together as we all call upon the Vice Chancellor to do welcoming and opening remarks. Professor Sakela Buhlungu, please, let's put our hands.
Thank you very much. Good morning, everyone, and good everyone who is live streaming into this event. Thank you very much, Mr. Pitti. You've made it very simple for me. I don't have to greet people over again. People have been acknowledged. It's a very short and very tight program. So I'm very pleased to stand here and welcome the Black Mambazo family. The Black Mambazo family. Let's give them a big hand. There. I'm starting with them because I want to make a very small point. In 2018, they were here with us. They were sitting there. That day, I never got to fulfill that wish. When they were performing, I had a wish to stand up and join them. And I was too shy to do it. I thought people were going to laugh at me. So today, if you see me sneaking in behind Mr. Mazibugo, you must just know I am dying to fulfill this wish. Let me greet the Shabalala family, especially Mrs. TV Shabalala. And of course, as I said earlier, the group is a family. And I'm not going to say this or this or that. That story is going to be told by the guest speaker. So we're very, very pleased. Senior management of the university, again, they've been introduced. I think you omitted to mention the registrar of the university, Mr. Jabulo Zuma. Welcome, Reg. I also am not sure if Professor Sheila from the ECAVC is here. She couldn't make it, yes. We have a center here, and I'm mentioning it on purpose once again because when Mambazo were here in 2018, they recorded, the studio is right there at the back somewhere. They recorded some song there with us. So we're very proud. We're coming far with this relationship. So thank you very much. All of these things, Dr. Sithole, we're going to give you an office downstairs. That's all. Because you were also here with us, facilitating a strategy workshop with us in 2018 or 2019. Yes, and I remember that very well. Again, it was for the audiovisual center. So an office and a key is coming your way. Thank you very much. And ladies and gentlemen, let's give ourselves a great round of applause for this great and historic event. Mm-hmm. let me welcome you to the university. Let me welcome you to the Faculty of Social Sciences and Humanities, and welcome you to the Department of Music and the Eastern Cape Audiovisual Center, because ultimately those are the hosts. Those are the people that speak the same language as Ladysmith Black Mambazo. Tina says, Mambela J. Those are the people who understand what the game is about. Welcome to the university. The inaugural Joseph Shabalala Memorial Lecture is a very important milestone for us. Back in 2019, we wrote a letter to the family. Mr. Majozi will remember this, the detail. We actually wanted to go to Ladysmith. One, to introduce ourselves and to pay our respects to Dr. Shabalala, who was ill at the time, so he couldn't move. So I said, we're going to move there. We're going to go there. Of course, I think the schedule of the band did not permit, and so we couldn't go. And just as we were thinking of rescheduling, we received with sadness the news of the passing of Dr. Shabalala last year in February. And so that all of those interactions were cut short. But the desire and the intention to forge this bond remained. Now, for some, it may not make sense. Why? Why is Fort Hare, Ladysmith, Black Mambazo, you're dealing here with two most resilient institutions. I'll use that word. Most resilient institutions that have played a leading part in developing black people in this country. And I'm using black people in the broadest possible sense. That's one. We've done it for 105 years. They've done it for 61 years. There's no university. Well, we're still going at 105. And in my recollection, at Dr. Stoyle, you will tell us this. I don't recall there's any single band, a music group in South Africa that has had such longevity as Ladysmith Black Mambazo, 61 years. They've come and they've gone, sadly, for various reasons. They are here. So it makes sense then. It stands to reason that we come together and reflect on our histories, on what we've done to build this country, what we've done to become ambassadors for this country in the various fields where we operate, but to develop people, to develop South Africans. You can't think of South Africa today without thinking of the University of Fort Hare. The story of this country will never be complete without the University of Fort Hare. Get it clear, everybody. Like it or don't like it, get it clear. That's it. You can never tell the story of this country in full without talking about this great institution of ours. It's resilient. It's strong. It's moving forward. And I dare say, I'm on different territory here, but you cannot tell the story of South African music or the story of South Africa, for that matter, without talking about Ladysmith Black Mambazo. You can't. It's impossible. It would be incomplete. It would be a travesty to talk about this country, to presume to talk about this country and its music without talking about this group. There's also, and if time permitted, and with some robust encouragement, I would even tell stories about how I, at boarding school, were brought up by music. Don't ask me when. I will tell that story later. We're brought up and inspired by music of Ladysmith Black Mambazo. We were brought up. As I said, if there was someone who was going to join me here and join me up, I would sing one of the songs. Yeah. I think it was made up. Maybe it was, but it tells the story so much about Black Mambazo. Because Black Mambazo, you come from your background, from your roots, from your villages. And the aspiration was go to the city, to Durban. Durban, in a way, was the point where people arrived and converged and forge these bonds amongst themselves. And the song, yo, ningahleki man. The song was a song, I think the young fellow our age who used to sing it was from Zimkulu. Now Zimkulu, you know, they deemed themselves to be closer to Durban, so to know it all. So the song was made up of 7 words, really, and repeated, that's all. But it was so uplifting because the words were interspersed with dancing and different things. I can see you're expecting me to sing now. No, if someone like Mr. Majosa would feel at least I have moral support next to me. But the song, it was something like this. Hamba zambezi etegwin, hamba yichona galo. Hamba zambezi etegwin, 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 hamba zambezi. That's the seventh a word. Hamba sambe siye etegwini, and then that's the seventh one. You get the drift. But it was that aspiration about the big city. The big city is a place of dreams, as a place where we could go and uplift ourselves. But a place that was rough too. I don't think it was just romanticized as a place where you just come and harvest the dreams. No, there was much more to it. So, there was that. I will not tell you about the other story because time does not permit. There's another Mambazo song which I could... No, it's not a Mambazo song, also made up song. These institutions are built by people. I think Professor Joseph Shabalala played the singular most crucial role in building the group. That is known, and the speaker is going to tell us about that. But also he was the kind of the glue that held it together, certainly from us looking from the outside. So having this lecture here, we're here to remember him. We're here to celebrate him. We're here to celebrate an institution, because that's what he was in the end. He was an institution. You'd have seen the moment of his passing and the moment of his funeral, his state funeral. It was a send-off fit for a giant. It was a send-off fit for a giant. That day, I pushed everything off. I watched on TV because that was the end of an era. But also, and thanks to him and his foresight, and I don't know how they did it, unlike many of us, we inherit organizations, we start them, and when we leave, they leave. When we leave, they collapse. But thanks to his foresight, and thanks to the group itself, the band is here with us, and they are thriving. And so what we're here to do is to explore how to forge this relationship. You will see that we're going to sign an agreement, an MOU. The contents don't matter at this stage. What matters is the principle and the commitment for us and the recognition that we belong together. We have the experience in building organizations and make them last and pass them on to the next generation. There aren't many people who can do that. You know, towns we inherited, they went down. Things we inherited, hospital, they went down. We are here. Ladysmith Black Mambazo, thanks to Mr. Joseph Shabalala. Just as I move to end, the other area we're very proud of is that actually unbeknown to many people, this university is home and custodian to archives, liberation archives. Started off with one party, but all the liberation movements have now deposited their archives here from 1991, 1992. Some of those archives have now been fully digitized, and the process continues. And I'm saying this is a call, this is a thing, this is the wish, this is one of the things that we wanted to sit around a fire with Professor Shabalala and the group in Nambiti. We wanted to sit around and we say, actually, we have experience in archives. We have experience in the preservation of legacies. We ourselves are a legacy. We ourselves have a legacy. So we have that. And one of the areas, obviously, that we're very keen to talk to about, that we hope the MOU will facilitate, is discussion in that area of preservation of archives, but also putting those stories, those histories, out there. Finally, Babum Shengu, I was looking at the pictures, at the stills on the screen. Whenever it performed, whether it was a still, a picture, or live, or a recording, he always exuded certain things, and you could not mistake them. He exuded passion for what he did. He loved what he did. He made no bones about it. He loved what he did. But also, in the truest sense, even before we had South Africa and the constitution and so on that we have now, 1994 and all of that, 1996, you had a committed South African here. Someone who wanted to build this thing that we have now and use his voice and use his craft and working with a band to do that. But also, he's someone who exuded love. There's no question about it. You can see that. He exuded peace. And in the end, as we get this lecture, therefore, from Dr. Sithole, I think all of us will pause and remember a person, a human being, a South African, a citizen of the world who lived his life to the fullest and bequeathed to us this band, but more than that, this music and this legacy. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Vice Chancellor. For the years we've been with the VC, this is his inaugural performance on stage. The VC has never sang, not even a chorus. Please. Thank you so much, Vice Chancellor, for reminding us of who we are, where we are, and how powerful these two brands are. You know, the human spirit is stronger than anything that can happen to it. Babu Shabalala may not be alive, but his spirit will live on. And this is how inspired we have been from the early ages we grew up knowing Ladysmith Black Mambazo. And even in the townships and villages of this country, there were so many Ladysmith Black Mambazos, and so many people's lives have been changed. Once more, thank you so much, Vice Chancellor, for reminding us that. And again, what a spectacular way of concluding this year, closing the year on a very high note as the University of Fort Hare. And now, ladies and gentlemen, join me in welcoming Mr. Xolani Majozi from the Ladysmith Foundation to give us the background to the culmination of this day. Can we clap hands for Mr. Majozi?
Sanibonani. Ninjani. Thank you very much, Program Director. Siyabonga kakhulu. Siyile the Smith Black Mambazo. Ukuthi sibe khona la, Fort Hare University. Njengoba ubaba u vice chancellor ubekile ukuthi we have ongoing relationship that started ngo 2019. So before that sifike la university Ladysmith Mambazo through e vision kababa u Professor Joseph Shabalala, the founder and the leader of Ladysmith Mambazo, had a vision of developing Italian around the country because he felt it's very important for the rich history and heritage Ladysmith Mambazo enayo ikwazi ukuthi imparte ama skills to emerging artists and also nokutshala imbewu to young people ukuthi bakwazi ukuthi umculo wesintu, indigenous music and our heritage through art bakwazi ukuthi bayipreserve futhi baziqhenye ngayo njengoba Ladysmith Mambazo ibehlezi iqembu elimele umculo wesintu for the past 60 years. And then we came up with a program maybe the Ladysmith Mambazo Mobile Academy, and we partnered with the National Department of Art and Culture. And that program was launched here at Fort Hare University. So that's where everything started. We are very grateful for that, and we're grateful that university opened doors for us to come and work with our students here at university and have that exchange program science and okufunda from young people and also befunda from Ladysmith Mambazo, which resulted in telling us to record a very beautiful song, and there was a great performance corner la university. So that partnership started, and we started to have our conversations ukuthi how can we have these two institutions working together because of the rich history both ama institutions anayo emlandweni. Sabuka ukuthi okunye okubaleke kakhulu ukuthi umlando isikhathi esiningi thina as ama Africa isikhathi esiningi sigcina ngokuxoxa singawubhali phansi singawudocument. We have great stories engomlando wethu, but ngenxa yokuthi i-story sixoxwa from one generation to another generation, you find that ezinye izinto ezi-rich ngomlando wethu ziyasilahlekela ngoba asizihluphi kakhulu ngokudocumenta. Ngoba even when we look at ama family trees wethu, mina njengoxolani Majozi, I think mengabheka kwi-family tree mhlampe I can go back mhlampe to a third generation, but ezinye izizwe ziyakwazi ukuthi uMajozi wayezalwa ubani, ezalwa ulukhozi, aza fike mhlawumbe on the seventh generation because they have a culture of preserving umlando wabo bakwazi ukuthi bawugcine. So we felt that let's work together in an institution whereby Ladysmith Mambazo will be able ukuthi isebenze ne university to preserve nokugcina umlando weLadysmith Mambazo, sikwazi ukucreate ama archives Ladysmith Mambazo from iqala ngo-1960 kuze kube manje, sibe nendawo la sizobeka khona umlando namagugu, so that lo mlando won't only help Ladysmith Mambazo and nabantu abathanda umculo, but izoba yingqolobani ezokwazi ukuthi isize ama-generations amaningi, sikwazi ukuthola authentic information ebhalwe phansi ebekiwe ukuthi Ladysmith Mambazo, the first Grammy eyayithola ngo-1997 kwakunini, kwakwenze njani, kube nendawo la sizoyibeka khona, because esikhathini esingesingakanani with Ladysmith Mambazo ne-foundation, we are planning to have a museum omculo nomlando weLadysmith Mambazo. So ezinye zezinto ezizosilekelela when we have an archive center, you will be able ukuthi ibe i-resource ne-information esizokwazi ukuyicollecta and share with ama-generations amaningi ezayo. So we are very grateful ukuthi that kind of conversation is taking is moving on the right direction, and we have agreed ukuthi lama institutions azokwazi ukuthi asebenzisane, because to have such great history Ladysmith Mambazo won't be enough if this history I share with young generation and the future generations so that they'll get inspired and babuke ukuthi kubaleke kangakanani ukuthanda izwe lakho kubaleke kangakanani ukuthi umculo kube into ehlanganisa abantu. And also yesterday we had a conversation no baba uMakhathini ukuthi besifisa ukuthi this kind of event siyenze ibe annual event because asifuni ukuthi umlando kaBaba Shabalala nomlando weMambazo ukhohlweke. So unyaka nonyaka siyafisa ukuthi iSouth Africa yonke iloke imcelebrate uBaba Shabalala because kukhulu akwenzile. So kuzosijabulisa kakhulu ke ukuthi we have a memorial lecture esikuhlelayo ngonyaka ozayo. Ngiyaxolisa kubaba u vice chancellor ngoba ubaba uNduduzo beke ngakambrief kahle ukuthi ke we'll have this program kodwa ke sesiya announce baba sekunjalo. So esifisa ukwenza ukuthi we have this memorial lecture ezokwenzeka iminyaka yonke sisebenzisana neuniversity. Okunye also we'll have a build up event. We want to have a Mambazo week that is going to be happening here kwi institution whereby nomuntu ongekho la njengoba kwenzeka bekhona abantu emakhaya as I media isinikeza a great coverage kube nesonto whereby iSouth Africa will be on standstill celebrating the life and the heritage of Ladysmith Black Mambazo, and it will be happening here. So lokho kuzosiza ukuthi sikwazi ukuthi siziqhenye ngokuthi singobani siphinde futhi si celebrate this great heritage Ladysmith Black Mambazo. So ke lokho okunye okubalekile we spoke about ukuthi iMambazo akulona nje iqembu la lase Ladysmith or lase KZN but iMambazo represent the continent through a culture and a heritage. Also is one of the best group njengoba eshilo u vice chancellor ukuthi ayiki group emlandweni eseke yaba kwi entertainment industry for 61 years ingakaze I break and also I achieve izinto iMambazo says achieve. So through I power yele Ladysmith Black Mambazo and a power ye institution that is respected in Africa yonke because iFote is not just also a university as a South Africa but a university yase Africa that represent the values and a heritage nomlando wonke owase Africa ubelonga kule institution. So having this two big brands working together, we want to do something called the African Heritage Concert because we always talk about heritage, but we don't go deep and ask ourselves, ukuthi, what does it mean to celebrate African heritage? Through this, as we know, ukuthi colonialism yasakhela imincele kwase khona ose Zambia, khona ose Nigeria, kanti we belong together, we are all Africans. So this event, tagline yakhona size sathi is going to be we'll be saying reconnecting Africa because the only thing that can reconnect Africa yonke is culture and is heritage, and Ladysmith Black Mambazo will be able to pull that working together with this great institution esisebenzisana naso. So ngaleyo ndlela sizobe sine responsibility of celebrating our African heritage. Sizobe sine responsibility of sharing in knowledge and inspire many people to tell great stories and to document ama stories wethu so that coming generation will know ukuthi singobani as ama Africans, how great it is to be an African, and sikwazi ukuthi sisebenze kanzima to make sure ukuthi umlando wethu uyagcineka. And ngalawo mazwi siyabonga kakhulu and siqhubeka siya phambili sizosebenzisana ne-institution and njengoba sishilo iLadysmith Black Mambazo are trendsetters kwi-entertainment industry globally. This institution is also futhi ama-trendsetters kwezemfundo. So let's have these great institutions working together to make a better Africa. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Mr. Majozi. Vice Chancellor, I could not believe what I see. That Black Mambazo is already fully booked for its tours to the US and Canada for 2022. And I got worried because that speaks to me and you that for wherever they go, we must be there. I think it's high time that we go to Home Affairs for fresh visas and all those things, because we are really going to be busy. January the 27th, they will be in New York. January the 28th, they will be in Massachusetts. 29th, New York City. 1st February, Wisconsin. February the 3rd, Ontario in Canada. My goodness, the list goes on. And I said, I wonder, does this audience realize that it's an honor and a special privilege for us to be in the room with this group? Because so many other people, they pay hundreds and thousands of dollars to be in the room with this group. But for us, thank you, Mr. Machos, it's going to be an annual habit. Whenever I see you on TV, I'll say, okay, Nazi Brazam. And ladies and gentlemen, can we put our hands together for Ladysmith Black Mambazo to come and give us? You do your things in doing Stumengazo. And also here at the university, I would love people when they identify me, but Ule Istalowe Mambazo. Azikhali Mambazo.
Yebo.
Ladies and gentlemen, once more, a big hand for Lady Smith, Black Mambazo.
Good morning to you all and to the viewers at home. Yeah. The song that we are going to sing for you now was written in 1964 by our leader, Professor Joseph Shabalala. And the song is Nomatemba. Wangishiela Nomatemba.
Selangi ngatwa unoma Thank you very much. Thank you. We'd like to sing you the following song. We wrote this song in 2019 in honor of our leader, Dr. Bekizizwe Joseph Shabalala.
People keep on asking.
People keep on asking. Where did you get the wings of light? It was our father, Joseph Shabalala. People keep on asking. Where did you get the wings of light? It was our father, Joseph Shabalala.
He is the one.
He is the one who had a dream of spreading our culture, the culture of South Africa, of love, peace, and harmony. We will never, ever forget
our
founder, Shen Shabalala.
We salute you.
We salute you. We are proud of you. Thank you.
We salute you.
We salute you. We are proud of you. Thank you.
Ikhawela milinye. Ikhawela mumshengu Shabalala.
Ikhawela milinye.
Ikhawela milinye.
Ikhawela mumshengu Shabalala. Kawela mide,
kawela mibu,
kawela mushe,
bayangibuza bantu,
kawela mide,
wo bayangibuza Baba, Kawela Matubani, Kawela Kumfa,
Kawela Milini,
Kawela Mi,
Kawela
Bayangi Buzabantu,
Kawela Milini,
Bayangi Buzaba,
Kawela
Matuwa Watola, Pamapigo,
Kawela Milini,
Wemfana Wasenam,
Kawela Musha,
Kawela.
Kawela Milini, Kawela Musha, Shabalala.
We are proud of you.
Kawela,
thank you, Sheikh Shabalala.
Kawela,
thank you, Sheikh Shabalala.
Kawela,
we salute you.
Kawela,
we are proud of you.
Kawela,
thank you, Sheikh Shabalala.
Kawela,
thank you, Sheikh Shabalala.
Kawela,
we salute you.
Kawela,
we are proud of you.
Kawela,
thank you, Sheikh Shabalala.
Kawela,
thank you, Sheikh Shabalala.
Kawela,
we begil into heaven.
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 Kawela,
Shabalala.
Kawela,
we kawela milinye.
Kawela,
we kawela mimina.
Kawela,
we kawela mi.
Kawela Mushe Shabalala.
Hamshengu
Kusho Tina Bakulus.
Mambazo kuzoba mnandi man. In our thought, you know, we will be safe. Ladies and gentlemen, a big hand for that performance. Amazing, amazing, amazing performance. You know, as in your dreams, Dr. Sithole, we live them whilst we're still alive. To me, it's like a dream, what I see here today. Thank you so much. Thank you. Thank you. And one other thing, how your father inspired you to follow suit. Just amazing. Thank you, guys. Thank you so much. And now, Prof Shabalala, on behalf of the family, our son Dale, Masum Kobelizan Labetun.
Ngafika kumama, ngafika kufamily, bonke abantu bedidekile. Nami ngididekile, ngingazi ukuthi kuzokwenzeka kanjani. But khona into engifisa ukuyibonga nokuyinothisa kule ndlu. Khona into ethi, when times are dark, friends are few. Akwenzekanga kanjalo. Sabona abantu bezosiduduza siwumndeni, samangala. Ngoba ubaba wayesehambile kanti kuvamisile ukuthi mase kuhambe into abantu abadonsayo bese beyahlehla. Okunye ngifuna ukugcizelela la ukubonga kakhulu abafowethu ngokuthi bayibambe la ku Ladysmith Black Mambazo. Mina by profession nje khona uprofessor ngizohlala kuyena because i field yami is teaching and learning. Teaching and learning. So ngizo sticker kuyena ngibone ukuthi lento esikhuluma ngayo iyenzeka yini. Ngesikhathi ubaba ehambile emhlabeni kwaba umlando emndenini waka Shabalala kwafika uMangameli kwathiwa amafleg awandizele phansi ngoba kuhambe uJoseph Shabalala obaba wethu. So siyajabula-ke ukuthi sizalwa yiqhawe elinjengalelia. But ngakumenishini ukuthi bonke abantu even including iLadysmith Black Mambazo kwakungelula ukusondela eduze kababa. Kakhulukazi makuthiwa kuya practice bangangivumela, akukho la ufaka khona ama-forms e-application ukuthi ngifuna ukucula neMambazo. Ngeke uyithole i-website enjalo whatever ukuthi nje hayi Mambazo ngifuna ukucula nani, ngenza u-1 no-2 no-3 ngine-degree ukuthi nokuthi never. You only have to come usondele. Make wasondela wafika nje ukuthi awunomlomo awucule ndoda awushayela. Sekuphelile-ke nangakusasa nangakusasa. Unalo ithuba ke sihambe khona la siyakhona siyocula khona. Uzothi ukuhleli kuthiwa was a stage. So iyona ndlela komukelwa ngayo. So kwakungelula-ke ngoba ukuhlala phansi upractice ulungisa lezi zinto ubaba ayifuna. Nami ugcina usudideka ungazi ukuthi yini efunakalayo. Uthi uyashaya kube khona into athi nakho-ke nakho-ke ubani lowo uthi hayi kade ngibhimba athi kona lokho engikufunayo. So akuzange kube lula. Ngake ngasho ngathi umama wake wacomplaina kwifamily ithi hayi bo mina bengizokhana kaShabalala bengezile ukuzocula ukuthi ngizovuswa ngo-2 kuthiwe khona iculo elifikayo awushaya u-alitha lapho bengakafiki. Wayethi yena uzogana kanti uma usoganile wenza konke okwenziwayo. Yokuthi umendo awuthunyelwa gundwane ngoba okunye ukufica ngaphakathi okade ungakulindele. So usuku olukhulu kakhulu kuthina somndeni wakaShabalala, siyabonga ngendlela yesimanga. Sizwe iy'ndaba ezimnandi. Recently besihambile siyifamily saya ePretoria umongameli ezohlonipha iqhawe lethu neqhawe lenu ngendondo which is the highest, basho njalo abaziyo, the highest award in the world, the Order of Kamanga in gold. Sabuya naye. Cela sishaye izandla. Sabakhombisa ababe khona. Kuthe kusenjalo kwafika upremier nelokhungana yakhe nethimba lakhe ekhaya kwaShabalala. Bathi ayi siyacela ukuthi nisenzele, sinenzele i-tombstone kaShabalala, kababa uShabalala ngoba bekungewona owefamily kuphela, bekuwumuntu wabo bonke abanye abantu. So sajabula kakhulu balenza i-tombstone. Uma ufika uyobona ubaba uShabalala la elele khona, uzofika ubone ukuthi upremier wase-KZN nebandla lakhe iwona umsebenzi abawenza basebe-hand over kumndeni wakaShabalala. Konke lokho kuyasijabulisa. Ngicela sishaye izandla. Ngiyajabula kakhulu ngoba umama ukhona family khona. Ngesikhathi kunomngcwabo kukhona uMangameli, abantu abaningi ngiye ngiyibuke leyo lokhungana leyo video, kukhona o-grandchildren baka-BJ Shabalala bangena baye stage bafike bacula benza lo babekwenza, kwanyakaza wonke umuntu. Umuntu wayekhona uma ngikhuluma ngale ngo-grandchildren uyabakhumbula. So ibona abantu-ke manje thina it's about to hand over the baton to the grandchildren. So uma kukhona i-university u-Fort Hare, ngiyakhumbula ngisafunda ngangazi nokuthi kukuphi, kodwa igama lalelikhulu ngicabanga ukuthi uma ngaye ngiyofunda e-university e-Fort Hare, eyi kusho ukuthi ngabe ngithole iziqu ey'phezulu, ngihlonishwe. Nama kuthi ufundaphi nje ngithi ngise-Fort Hare, bonakala ukuthi ngifundile ngempela. So namhlanje kube iphupho ukuthi ngibe la ngizoma ngikhulumela ubaba noma engasekho, kodwa kuyasijabulisa siwumndeni. So ngicabanga ukuthi i-foundation lene khona iyona ethi ngisize ukuze nami ngikwazi ukusiza abanye. Uma singakhuluma nabafowethu sesiqedile thina noma it's about to finish manje sekufanele sihandi bethini go grand children ka BJ Shabalala baningi bangachala lendlu wababona bababona besukuma lapha so ke ngalamazi amafishane ngiyabonga ukuthi iuniversity is paving the way. I'm also sure that it's paving the way for the grandchildren of BJ Shabalala, not for us, because Shabalala was not working for himself. Ekhaya thina ubaba besingamazi bangangifakazela bafowethu mayengekho epesheya esekhaya useGoli uma ekhona ekhaya ubhizi nabanye abantu simbona nje ngaleso sikhathi ebhizi ngaleso sikhathi. So yingakho ke kuvele kwaqhamuka kwathiwa for umhlaba wonke uyakhala ngokudlula kwababa Shabalala uyamkhumbula ngeendlela eziningi. So ke ngalamazwi amafishane ifoundation, to my understanding, it's only to help me or only to help the family Shabalala so that the family Shabalala can help others. So ke ayazi ukuthi sino grandchildren ake ngenze example ngokuba mnandi kanjani uma kungathiwa ake ngiyibale mina ngaba lo munye umuntu uma kungathiwa indodana kaShabalala iyothola iziqu eFort Hare ngoba malikhona ithuba ngahlala phansi kulomnyaka nje ngahlala phansi ngenze lokho okufundwayo terms and conditions zambe zama ukumitha ama terms and conditions of the university. So njoba sikhuluma ngehistory and making sikhuluma ngezinto ezinjalo. Kungaba mnandi kanjani uMama Shabalala kababa uShabalala ethola iziqu e-university of Fort Hare. Kungamnandi kanjani uSibongiseni umsizi uThulane uThami kuthiwa uzothwesa ijazz lobudokotela. Uthweswa yiphi university? IFort Hare. Kungamnandi kangakanani the grandchildren, not of the Shabalala family now, the grandchildren of LBM come and study at the University of Fort Hare and he get his graduation there. That is history in the making. So ngibona ngijuluka nje ngijulukela lokho ukuthi abantu abaningi abeza ngemuva who are our grandchildren, we are about to handle the battle to them. So the university and others are paving the way ukuthi izinto ezenzakalayo zenzeleke ngendlela kube lula, because it was not easy at first, but it worth it. Abakwazi ukubhala kahle basho njalo, kwakungelula nje ukuyo practice. Ngake ngasho ngelinye ilanga uba mazibukwa igcine sesele yedwa uma uke wezwa thina sibuya esikolweni osibongiseni babe khokhoba ngeke kuye la kupractizwa khona amambazo ngoba uzohlala kuze kushone ilanga. Zonke izinto kade uyihlelile ukuthi uzozenza, you can't do it. Uma usuhamba funeka uphume ngathi uyochama unyamalale. But sasingaziki ukuthi kuzoba noju olulolu hlobo. So ngalamagama amafishane siyabonga kakhulu university. Siyabonga ukuthi nisimeme size la. Kodwa nathi siyajuluka kunabantu abangemuva, which is our grandchildren of the family of Shabalala and the grandchildren of the family of LBM. That's why maybe they try to do the foundation so that you can help us and then we're going to help the others. Not only the children of us, but the community as such. Aye. Umnandi.
Thank you so much, Dr. Shabalala. Siyabulela kakhulu. Nam didi hi. Nazi specs is a co. As I was coming down here this morning from home. And there is this song that I always play.
in the list of many Black Mambazo songs. The one that you guys recorded with Andres Vollenweider. Ngiyajabula mina, ngiyajabula. Ngiyajabula mina, ngiyajabula. Ngiyajabula mina, ngiyajabula. That's the feeling I have today. It's amazing. I'm living my dream. As I'll be driving back home, that song will be playing time and again because I've been with the Mambazo. Thank you once more. Inkosi kakhulu Baba Shabalala. Our own jazz maestro, our very own. I feel so pity for Peter Maritzburg. We continue to take and adopt all their sons. Now they belong here. Our own, you know, wherever he is, we know he's carrying our emblem. Duduzo Makatini, come and introduce to us our keynote speaker for today. A big hand for Duduzo, please.
So much. So because I know I'm very passionate about the speaker and also the person that we are celebrating today, so I decided to write some of these things down so I don't take forever. So given the fact that, you know, we have very limited time already, the greetings have already been done, but I would like to do a collective greeting in the spirit of our ancestors that broke from the reeds. Ngizothi siyathokoza. Nina kufanele nithi siyavuma. Thokoza. So this, I think this is a relevant kind of greeting, especially, you know, given the nature of this kind of gathering that is here but at the same time elsewhere, in a sense that the person that we're remembering is in another dimension. So it's very important to be cognizant of that and kind of make an invitation open beyond maybe what we see around us. So this is a very difficult task. I have two main functions, I believe, to perform here. On the one hand, I need to introduce the speaker, and on the other hand, to kind of lead into some of the themes that are inherent in his paper. But like I say, it's a difficult task because the speaker wouldn't allow me to browse his paper. So I've asked for it for over 2 weeks now, and he just said no. Okay. But anyway, I think that, you know, sits very well with the nature of my practice as an improviser, but eobungoma as well. So, you know, I really have to throw the bones here. And so I'm going to do my best in throwing those bones and hope they're accurate enough. Many people have said that Africans are born into stories. And this one time an author, Ben Okri, said they are born actually with stories. And today I want to propose that they are also born with songs. And of course, I want to add that, like, these Africans in themselves live inside these songs. So changing the whole idea of a composer as being superior than the song itself, but this idea of homelessness that I know you're going to touch on, at least amathamba angjela. So, like, creating songs as ways of building these homes. So when Baba Shabalala, for instance, was saying, homeless, you know, but there was still a song to live inside of. There is something to be said again about how the story in itself has two functions. On the one hand, it gives a responsibility to us, the ones that are living, to tell the story. So this is the storing, the telling of the story. But there is also another function, which is the storing the things that live inside. So we are both telling the story, storing and storing. And I think this is kind of in line with a lot of what's been said today about legacy, about memory. It is the work of memory against this very difficult backdrop of the global South, as we know it, that has been pushed over many years to this very intense amnesia. This is not surprising as well, since the core project of the colonial moment was that of erasing the histories of the colonized subject and from their library and inject those of the West. And what Mudimbe maybe refers to as the colonial library, that even in this moment of decolonizing, we find ourselves still looking in the wrong direction of a library that doesn't have our authorship. So an avid musicologist named Agau speaks about how, for instance, tonality was used as part of the colonial tools. So it's rare that we think about something like tonality as something that informs a way of being in the world. While this is true, there is also a sense in which Isicathamiya uses language and particular musical gestures against these prescriptions of the West and the Western vocabulary, and in a way trying to push against this library. Now the next speaker discusses, I guess, the role of song in these difficult historical moments. He brings to focus the idea of songs as instruments of producing a mode of refusal. The spirit of the next presentation thus allows us to turn back to the sonic as spaces for citation, as spaces for remembering and recollection. In other words, the next speaker gives context not limited to why particular songs are important, but only to why the composers, such as Professor Shabalala, broke into distinct sounds inside these very complex historical moments. I was also again warned to not try and improvise the biography, because I know him as a mentor and he wears so many other different caps, and perhaps he didn't want to mention those kinds of caps deliberately. So I'm just going to read a bit about his biography. So Dr. Sipho Sithole is a research fellow at the Johannesburg Institute of Advanced Study at the University of Johannesburg. He holds a PhD in anthropology from Wits University, a master's degree from the London School of Economics, as well as a political science and international relations degree from Lincoln University in Pennsylvania. Dr. Sithole, his research interests rather are marginality, belonging, culture and celebration, migration, which is a theme that keeps coming back in the Mambazo story, this idea of, moving between Johannesburg and Nasekhaya, and I know you're going to take us through that. Also, he speaks about post-coloniality, the reimagining, identity politics, as well as culture and the creative economy. Now, without any further ado, please welcome on the stage the great Dr. Sithole.
Yes. Isangoma ngempela. What an honor. I think ngesiZulu bathi inhlanhla engandelwe umuntu le. Ukuthi ngicela uzokhuluma ngeqhawe. Who really is a cultural institution in this country. I refuse to give him my paper. I think it's also because ngilibhale for over 2 weeks, ngaliqeda ekuseni ngo 2 o'clock this morning. So I always felt with I gotta feel like funny figure corner. But still, I wasn't gonna give it to you anyway. I was not going to give it to you. Program director, tell one who lays there.
Oh, yes.
Yes. Program director. Firstly, allow me to say I'm really mindful of and sensitive to the site and place where I'm standing. The place we know today as East London, but we also know that it was originally inhabited by the Khoi and the San people, and later followed by amaXhosa. So when I arrived here at East London Airport, I saw King Palo. It reminded me of the book that I have called The House of Palo. So I'm not sure whether there is any relation to him having been in this area. But we also know that that was before the battle that started in 1835, which ensued, which was actually being pursued by a governor of the Cape Colony, Sir Benjamin Durban, who is best known for his frontier policy to the Buffalo River, where he was seeking a future port to supply the province of Queen Adelaide, as the area was known, by the way. But I won't get to that because that's another story for another day. But I'm also aware of the fact that where I'm at, the Miriam Makeba finds its home, is an academic institution that has produced creme de la creme of the continent's best political minds that saw the birth of liberation movements and government of newly independent African states. Amongst those who studied at Fort Hare and later became leaders of their countries were Kenneth Kaunda of Zambia, Seretse Khama of Botswana, Yusuf Lule of Uganda, Julius Nyerere of Tanzania, Robert Mugabe and Joshua Nkomo of Zimbabwe. And of course, here at home, other notable figures and alumni such as Nelson Mandela, Governor Mbeki, Oliver Tambo of the African National Congress, Umntwana wakaPhindangene, uPrince Mangosuthu Buthelezi of Inkatha Freedom Party, Desmond Tutu, and of course, uRobert Sobukwe of the Pan-African Congress, who, by the way, gave a speech to the class of 1949, a graduating ceremony. And I'm gonna quote just 2 lines that he said, which I think the Vice Chancellor was echoing. He said, Fort Hare must be to the African what Stellenbosch is to the Afrikaner. It must be the barometer of African thought. And I think it has continued on that trajectory. And today is just a culmination of that as well. Therefore, there could not have been any better institution to host such a memorable lecture on one of South Africa's cultural ambassadors and cultural export that this country has ever produced, other than here at Fort Hare's Miriam Makeba Center. But before I begin, I need to acknowledge, and you'll allow me, VC, I know you've done that before, but I have to say it. And first, greet the Joseph Shabalala family, and also Mama, Mrs. TV Shabalala. I was at an event 2 weeks ago in Ladysmith. Bebembiza ngosisi Zodwa, the wife of the late Joseph Shabalala. And also Mr. Nkosinathi Shabalala, thank you for the words of support that you have just given. The members of the Ladysmith Black Mambazo, Ladysmith Foundation, including Albert Mazibogo, as well as the manager, Mr. Ekolan Majozi. And of course, the members of this multi-Grammy-award-winning group, Ladysmith Black Mambazo, and the fans of the group around the world who are probably watching this. I then want to acknowledge the presence of the Vice Chancellor, Professor Sakela Buhlungu, the Deputy Chair of Council, Dr. Sipho Sithole, the Vice Chancellor, the Deputy Vice Chancellor of Teaching and Learning, Professor Renuka Vital, and the Deputy Vice Chancellor of Institutional Support, Dr. Oscar van Heerden. I think he would have been the COO maybe at corporate. Yeah, that's what they would call it. And of course, the Dean of Social Sciences and Humanities, Professor Rose, Head of Music, and award-winning jazz maestro, Mr. Nduduzo Makatini himself. And I also saw Dr. Sipho Sithole, who happens to sit as an advisory panel member of the National Arts Council, where I'm a council member. And all of them have joined here in person for this great occasion. But I also want to say that I would be amiss if I don't acknowledge all the Isicathamiya groups who paved the way for the groups that followed thereafter. And I'm talking about Solomon Linda and his group Evening Birds. By the way, Solomon Linda, who composed Imbube, which became Mimowe and The Lion Sleeps Tonight, he attended a school about 500 meters away from my village, Msingalang, and Pumakon. A. Natalie, all of this group of back in the day, Nabayabe Sutu, Easy Walkers, Happy Boys, King Star Brothers, Lamini Home Defenders, Newcastle Five Roses, Xolo Homeboys, GMC. Now, each GMC, they named themselves after, is it a Ford or a chef? Ford, they were working at GMC factory, and they named themselves after that, they called themselves GMC. Even Nali Kembu, Albert Mazibu, who's one of the longest serving members of Ladysmith Black Mambazo and also founders, co-founders of Mambazo, Albert Mazibuko, his group was called Zulu Motors. Angando mani ikumbula ni Zulu Motors. Wagulu ya sweet lo pala, wote ngazi ngaktan, dandombe ngati ngati nje manga. You know? Maningi kama kembu. But I think also I will be amiss if I don't recognize those who have carried the baton today, who still keep this genre alive. I attend a lot of Ongo Mapsugu mina. When I left Ladysmith 2 weeks or 3 weeks ago, I was rushing to Togoza Hostel, Egoli, because there was Ingoma yokuqeda unyaka. Labe edlana khona imlala, amaqembu abala ko 1820, zigqoke kahle, zishama suit anzima. This is the culture that no one knows, but it's there, because they don't see it. But it has survived for the longest time. And of course, the work of Joseph Shabalala and Mambazo have done that. So those groups today, I won't mention all of them, but I just need to mention the one that I remember. Zulu Messengers, Ezra Umfoga Vulak Valiwe, Umfoga Mhlongo. Ipumo Recording Stars, Zagiti, Ezra Umashefa Ngembazo, Umfoga Mkwanas. Inkululeko, Ey Hola Umfana Mwane Wasemzi Mkulu, Ekutuwa Umkele, Umfoga Ngele. Iladysmith Hlanganani, Ezra Sungula U 7 Seconds. You remember Ingoma Ka Kandina Sherry, no, Yusundo, 7 seconds. Umfoka kunene ongasekho. Bese uba Color by Boys. It's very interesting ngoba leli gama leli Color by Boys. It's actually has got political connotations. It's got to do with Calabar. So when they were experiencing this racial exclusion and all of that, whites only benches and whites only whatever, they then named themselves Color by Boys. As Holo Busan Umfoka Bhengu. General Singers, Espetho Mahlobo kaNtombela. Amabutho Embube ezikampendula umfoko adlala isikhalo seAfrica ngqo ezikantokozo umfoko aluvuno neDouglas Happy Boys ezihola uShoti umfoko ambatha neNew Generation ezingaphansi kwalakhe phakathi and of course imtuba Thulisa Brothers igenge engiyazi kakhulu ngake nga contribute ukurecord i-album yabo ngayirelease under my what they call it imprint Native Rhythms Heritage Series uDlubheka umfoko Ndima but there's a group here locally angana wabakhona nikuthi uyi-Black Heroes eyake yathi ukugijima nemambazo imambazo ivakashile ngithe nabangibarecognize but finally to the Miriam Makeba Center here at Fort Hare University in East London campus for hosting this occasion and inviting me to speak at Professor Joseph Shabalala's memorial lecture. Now I want to start my speech here today by first stating that one cannot talk about the founder of Ladysmith Black Mambazo. Now, sizobona ke whether ubhule kahle nimuchitha amathambo wenduduzo. and the late Professor Joseph Shabalala without first locating him within an atrocious system of colonialism, apartheid, displacement, and ultimately forced labor migration, which gave rise to what I call the reluctant migrants. Because we didn't come to the city because we wanted to. The circumstances forced us to come to the city. And I need to unpack this so that one can have an understanding and appreciation of the harsh circumstances that gave us Joseph Shabalala and his contribution to what has become the most appreciated sonic signature and cultural expression to come out of South Africa. Our appreciation for Joseph Shabalala's work and his contribution to this music demands of us to peel off and expose the social political layers and hidden texts of a very difficult rural life that resulted in an unintended flight to the cities by a lot of Africans that we all find ourselves here, who would have rather remained back at home in the village. And unfortunately, that home, talk about homeless, had been snatched from them through a deliberate and systematic system designed for Africans to ultimately come to the city as migrant laborers, reluctant as they were. And this requires us to reimagine Joseph Shabalala and Isicathamiya within a colonial context and how he reacted to this colonial encounter and how he reconstructed his own life and unshackled himself from the system of apartheid and colonialism. And so to understand Joseph Shabalala, I am also reminded by one scholar, W.L. Newman, who argued that creative, adaptive people with unrealized potential, trapped by illusion and exploitation, will find ways to create meaning to make a sense of their worlds. We'll talk about how Shabalala comes to the city and being a creative and adaptive person creates and find a meaning and then create his own world, which is the world that we are talking about here today. And I think Newman compels us to admit that we cannot simply celebrate the songs of migration and the influence behind the compositions, including Joseph Shabalala's rise to stardom, without laying bare the pain and the scars of social exclusion, deception, and the degrading conditions under which the pioneers of Isicathamiya wrote the songs that have captured the imagination of the world at large. But if we do not confront these issues, we will be absolving colonialism and apartheid and simply deduce that Isicathamiya and Joseph Shabalala happened spontaneously and freely and did not arise out of a colonial encounter. Therefore, before we even move forward, the fundamental question that we must ask ourselves, I think Ndutuza spoke to on his introduction, is who is going to put colonialism on trial? I can tell you right now that it is not the institutional criminal justice system and the international criminal court, because that is a colonial construct by nature. We are the ones who must put colonialism on trial. We, the scholars, the writers, the musicians, the composers, the poets and the playwright, we must put this system on the accused stand and remind it why there was a Joseph Shabalala in the first place and what could have become of him had he not beat the system. What if God had not favored him with a blessing and a gift to dream, the ability to observe society from within and to write about it, and the overwhelming urge and courage to leave his homestead at a young age, which I'll speak to, for a city that knew no mercy. And when I say this and ask who's going to put colonialism, who's going to tell the stories? You spoke about the stories, Sango Malisi. We must tell these stories because Chinua Achebe reminds us that it is the storyteller who makes us what we are, who creates history. The storyteller creates the memory that the survivors must have, otherwise their surviving would have no meaning. So we need to go back come back here, remind us why. I was saying to Ndudu the other day that it's one thing to tell history, to be a historian, but it's also one thing to say, why did the events happen? The history behind the history. Angithi kufanele ke sikhuluma amaqiniso namhlanje, sigeqa amagula. And yes, we must do this without fear or favor, singesabe. Because we are talking about iqhawe. Who could have perished in the farm, white farm, but he came here to the city in Durban and made meaning of his own world. Now let me share with you why we must celebrate Professor Joseph Shabalala, VC. First of all, Joseph Shabalala was not supposed to come to Durban in the first place. The colonial system was designed in such a way that farm tenants were meant to toil on the farm until their last days on earth. Now, when I say that, I get reminded because those that were toiling on the farm even after our democracy, which we are still within, by the way, and when they died on those farms, they used to say, we're not going to bury you here, go to Mandela to find you a burial site. And yet, all they'd ever known was being on the farm. And I will explain how they find themselves on the farm. So they were supposed to toil on that farm until the last day on the earth, and then their children were supposed to take over if their families were to remain on a farm as tenants. Otherwise, they were going to be chucked out. So Joseph Shabalala would not have been spared from this eventuality. Even his children that are sitting here would have followed suit and become farm workers. I'm talking about Obaba Nkosinathi, Osibongiseni, Othami, Othulani Nomsizi nabanye. Had he not broke loose and left. Maybe it was his own underground railroad, Zabo Harriet Tubman. So working and eventually dying on the farms seems to be the only fate for all farm tenants who suddenly found themselves squatters on the land of their forefathers. And in this case, I'm talking about the land of the Zulus, which stretched from the border of Mozambique to the banks of Umtamvuma River on the border of Eastern Cape. But what happened? 2/3 of arable and productive land was carved out by the colonial regime and given to white farmers and missionaries. And by the way, it was expropriated without compensation. The remaining 1/3 dry and uninhabitable land was demarcated as native reserves. Now, please note the word reserve. It means after having helped yourself with the productive land, Bashi and Umhlabanji, they knew had no use, they had no use for, and sort of reserved it for us, for natives as they called us. So those that found themselves trapped inside what had become white farms had to work the land if they were to continue to stay there as labor tenants. And when the parents were too old to work on the farms, young boys and girls had to work on the farm. Now remember that after you've carved the land, you have given 2/3 and then 1/3 you've got the farmers who now have taken over the land, but they found natives living there. They naturally then become tenants on the land that the white farmers had found them. And this is what happened to the person we are talking about today. So young able-bodied men had to take turns to work on the farm. And also there was something called isibalo. The historians will remember this. You worked 6 months in public works program for a government, or you go in, and then you have to come and work 6 months on the farm. You had to work the 6 months on the farm, otherwise they will chuck you out. That's how you paid to stay on the farm. And that's where Joseph Shabalala came from. Now, but Joseph Shabalala was going to have nothing of that, none of that. He had another plan. A young Joseph Shabalala left his parents' homestead where they were farm tenants on the eve of New Year in 1959. I do want us to think of and imagine Joseph Shabalala, not the one that you know today. Think of this young man at the age of 18 who boards a train to Durban on the eve of New Year. It was going to be 1960 the following day, but he left. and he came to the city of Durban to start a life of a migrant worker, not Isicathamiya. He didn't know that he was going to, of a migrant worker. At a tender age of just 18, he arrived at an unknown and unfamiliar place, probably carrying a dombolo nenkuku. Kwakukhona namaqebelengwa laba ababehamba ngenyawo for 3 weeks, ngoba phela angithi akuboli. So yena wahamba ngesitimela mhlawumbe amnike idombolo nenkukhu ukuthi uma efika lapho mhlawumbe uma ezofika ehostel athi uphetheni, hayi nayo inkukhu yasekhaya. To eat on the way, but a new world suddenly opened up for this young man, but and he was up to it. So when I was listening to the song Homeless, much as I never got to ask him why did he write the song, but when he left the for the city on New Year's Eve of 1959, he literally became homeless. He was 18. And I want you just to play a bit of that, just 30 seconds of Homeless. It's fine. Because I want to make a point that Ubeola Lemaweni, he left with nowhere to stay, but he knew he was going somewhere because he was not going to stand the life on the farm. So it's better to go and die somewhere if he had to, but not on the farm. Joseph Shabalala was not going to be homeless. But how he deals with this new world is unprecedented. Of course, life on the farm had prepared him for anything. A young man who had already lost his father at the age of 12, and to grow very quickly, cowering at the hands of the colonial farmers and later at the hands of the capitalists and apartheid bosses in Durban was not going to be an option for him. So leaving for the city at the age of 18 was not by choice, but was out of necessity to escape a village life or a farm life whose soul had been sucked dry by years of colonial rule and exploitation. And those who follow the systematic destruction of the Zulu kingdom will understand the context of what I'm alluding to here. And I want to keep on you imagining a young man at the age of 18. So what I'm saying is that whilst we must celebrate the life and times of Joseph Shabalala through his notable local and global success, and truly so, we must also remember a youthful life that was snatched from his cradle, forced to live a life of a matured adult male in a city that knew no mercy. Joseph Shabalala never got to enjoy a life in the village where young people got to search for iqanda lenjelana. Those are who are coming from where I come from, they know. He was already searching for a job when his peers were searching for amathunduluka and hunting his agwaca nonogwaca. When young people back at home of his age went about their youthful chores in the village, behambela udwendwe, weddings, bephuma umgangela, beshela, beqonywa, baze bagxumeka iduku elimhlophe, sometimes more than one duku, ngoba bebeqonywa nje, beqonywa nje, zibe intombi zibe 4 or 5 nje gxumeka iduku elimhlophe. Yeah. He was already in a city that was unforgiving to Africans and who did not enjoy the same privilege like white colonialists did. I meant to bring my bottle with me, I call. Induduzo bese ikhulume kahle lapha. So what happens then when Joseph Shabalala gets to Durban?
Very interesting.
I took a trip one day from Egoli ngaya eClermont to meet Babu Albert Mazibuko, the remaining original member of the Mambazo. Ngaya eClermont. And that was last year, by the way. I didn't know about what was about to happen. So he gets to Durban and he gets a job as a general worker at a cotton factory called Frame Textiles. This is now in 1960. But he soon returns back in 1961 to work on the farm because if he doesn't, bazoxosha umndeni. So he went back again. 1960 he works at Frame Textiles. 61 he goes back to fulfill the terms and conditions that we are talking about. So that his family can keep the homestead inside the farm. And a year later, he again returns to Durban, worked at various firms, including Super Concrete and Penta Chemicals. Now, when you search about Penta Chemicals, they say, why a chemical engineer? Madlala ngayo baba, but we chemical engineer. Umuntu ubiza uqovu penda. Kuthi chemical engineer, you know? Those who studied in the US will know that ama cleaner, they call them sanitary engineers. Yeah, umuntu usebenza nje la Miriam Makeba uya cleaner nje, kuthi sanitary engineer. And he eventually worked at Greenacre Construction. Some of us, we know Greenacre until LTA, those big construction firms, much cooler, yeah? At Greenacre Construction, Joseph Shabalala would later recruit Albert Mazibuko. Also, come back born in Sizwagit. He recruits Albert Mazibuko in 1967. And Albert will tell you a story of how himself, he once got a job at Super Concrete, the same firm that Professor Joseph Shabalala had worked at before. He got a job in 1964. I think he had just arrived in 1964 in New Germany. And he says, when they started that day, when they were recruited, they were 15. They were 25. At the end of the day, 15 were remaining. And the last three that worked at Super Concrete were three. And it was him as well. Because Naye, he came from a nearby farm, so he knows what it is like to toil. Now, the beauty about back then is that you could come to the city, back in you get a job. And it was easy for friends and relatives to speak to Induna emsebenzini, ikufake emsebenzini. Today you can't, ngoba kuthiwa hayi nepotism ne corruption. But they were able to do that. Now, there is something phenomenal about labor migrants, about music in motion, Nduduzo, and cultural memory. You spoke about cultural memory. I was like, this guy, winjonjili pepalami. When Africans, as reluctant migrant workers, were recruited to the cities, either as mine workers, general laborers, housekeepers, and garden boys, they also took with them village songs, sung at wedding ceremonies, and at other cultural celebrations, but will refashion them in more contemporary styles, Isicathamiya. Ngoba they use ingoma zasemakhaya, zempoloho lapha emshadweni, and then they will reinterpret them. And when I was thinking about that, it reminded me of the song, and I'm not sure whether how one can change it into Isicathamiya, but that's where those songs came from. You remember the ingoma ethi, sengingedwa kubaba no mama. Sengingedwa kubaba, sengingedwa kubaba no mama. Sengine ngaba ka vele mina ayiwe vele mina ay sengine ngaba ka vele mina ayiwe vele mina we baba mina ay ma iqembu elenza isikhwela jo I think lengoba bangayiqala ngenye indlela bangathi sengingetwa kubaba nomama sing. You know, and ngoba angithi Isicathamiya siza ngendlela eyiningi khona isikhwela jo khona is home khona amahubo khona ikhetho. I don't know whether Mambazo yenza ikhetho, or I get a sense ukuthi mhlawumbe umculo wa Mambazo iphuma kuleso style leso, but it also depended on the group's origin and their sonic signature. So it is through these songs of migration that Isicathamiya groups were formed by migrants either from the same village or from the same region. And these songs were influenced by what they had sung at traditional ceremonies. This is evident from the story that Albert Mazibuko tells me about his first encounter with Professor Joseph Shabalala. Mazibuko also worked, by the way, in an adjacent farm where Shabalala also worked. And he tells me that yabona uShabalala ubebizwa kuyo yonke imicimbi la kuzoba khona wedding ceremonies, makuthiwa nje kunemibholorho or imfundelo practicing for weddings, because he was a skilled lead of that. That is where he was known. Kuthi yabona mawuya lapho kukhona khona uShabalala kuyoshada uyena ngithiwa umbidi. Umbidi ubuwazi kahle ukuthi hayi uma kuthiwa mhlambe uphuma kwiqembu lawo makodi uyena olidalwa yiyona elizowina or umkhwenyana yilona elizowina. And at that time, Albert was only 10 years younger than Joseph Shabalala. But he was already working on the farm, by the way, Albert. And Albert Mazibuko tells me that he would follow his idol wherever he went. Wherever there was a wedding, he knew there was going to be Joseph Shabalala. And he would follow him. So one day, Albert Mazibuko puts on his well-ironed pants and shirt. And he decides that he would walk to Joseph Shabalala's homestead. He had never met him. He knew him from a distance. So Umazibuko shay iblukwe lakhe nesikhindi sakhe lapho neshirt uayinile uyahamba. He decides that he's going to walk to the homestead, the nearby farm. And then he arrives there. Ushabalala is not there. He's working. He's toiling on the farm somewhere. So he introduces himself to Joseph Shabalala's mother. He says, "Hayi kamalam, Albert Mazibuko. Kanje kanje ngiphuma kule the nearby farm. I'm here to visit Joseph," as if he's his friend now. "I'm here to visit Joseph Shabalala." So Umama says, "No, he's not, but he's going to come back." So Joseph arrives, and the young man who's 10 years younger than Joseph Shabalala says, "I'm Albert Mazibuko Kanje. I like you, your work and your singing and all of that." He tells me there was not much conversation. He just listened that, "Okay, I'll see you next time. We will see each other." And then off leaves a happy, very happy Albert Mazibuko that he has met with Joseph Shabalala. But they then meet later. So when in 1964, Mazibuko, at the age of 16, also finally leaves for Durban. Now this is very interesting. Shabalala was 18 when he came to Durban. Solomon Linda was 22 in 1931. He was the youngest of any migrant worker that left, also escaping the conditions in the farms. And he goes to Durban. This young man in front of us. So for him, it was obvious that he had to escape the conditions on the farm. And also, Isicathamiya then played a role in the orientation of new arrivals to urban life. Him and Joseph Shabalala would eventually hook up in Claremont. And I think where I also went to see Albert, it was this is where Shabalala lived and he had his house. And by that time, Joseph had already founded a group called Ezimnyama in 1967. Before that, he had been part of some group called Highlanders and all of that. But he founded a group called Ezimnyama. And it's clear that Joseph had honed his skill on the farm back home when he led rival wedding groups through highly spirited traditional songs, whether he was on the groom's or on the bride's party. So arriving in Durban, he defaulted to form a group singing Isicathamiya. Now, Ezimnyama was a sequel to a group he first formed called Lover Span, and later the Durban Choir. Just like Solomon Linda did in 1931 at the age of 22, Joseph Shabalala, in his defined resolve to find a different purpose in life and how to engage and live in a city that was ready to turn him into a perpetual migrant worker, he found solace in Ungoma Busuku. Naming the group Ezimnyama also shows Joseph Shabalala's highly political consciousness and identity. The group was unapologetically black. Ironically, I'm also told that the name Ezimnyama was only used when the group was in the city in front of white people to say, "Hey, in case you forget, we are black and this group is called Ezimnyama." But when the same group went back to the village, they would change their name to Durban Choir. Now, alternating between the two names and had interesting contradictions and connotations, in that the group embraced and disowned the city when they were in Durban. In the city, they asserted themselves and their presence by assuming the name that identifies with who they were, Ezimnyama, the black ones. But changing the name to Durban Choir every time the group returns home, Mazibuko says this was to brag to the young adults there, males, still stuck on the farms, that born they are from the city. So they are just called the Durban Choir. And everyone loved this group. Durban Choir, bapume Durban, you know? So in the villages, the Durban Choir would come back and rekindle with a long-held tradition of night music and celebration, albeit taking more a different shape and style. So returning migrants will come home to festivities of rituals and of either coming of age, umemulo, or wedding ceremonies that start in the night and continue throughout the day. So we are all familiar with this history and how he quickly immersed himself in this music. So when Joseph Shabalala subsequently formed the group Ladysmith Black Mambazo, his first breakthrough was getting a record deal with Gallo Records in 1972. After being spotted at a competition, hosted by Radio Bantu back then, which is now Ukhozi FM. The rest is history. In 1973, their debut album, Amabutho, was released by Gallo Mavutela Records, which catered for only black artists. I once asked, by the way, Joseph Shabalala, that his first recording deal, did he get an outright purchase like they did to Solomon Linda? Or did he sign a contract and wanted to earn his royalties? What not? You know, we did not want to be given an outright purchase. When Solomon Linda did that song, Imbube, back then they paid him out. So thank you for the song, Nangu Pondo. Little did they know that that song was going to be the biggest song in the world, remodeled by many artists, big artists in the world, to Mimowe, to The Lion Sleep Tonight, and taken by Disney to be used in The Lion King. Shabalala says, no, Tina, we said, no. And it's Gusniga Tino Pondo. Tina, we'll sign a contract, we are artists, we own everything, our compositions, you will pay us for the sales of records in accordance with our record artist agreement. And you will recall that. So he then decides to call the song Amabutho. Now, Amabutho has got very serious political connotations. This is 1973. Now go back to 1878, when King Cetshwa was given 13 ultimatums by Henry Bethel Frere. Number 7 of those ultimatums was that the Zulu kingdom or the Zulu king will no longer have an organized military system. They will never have a regiment to Amabutho. That was, you could be arrested. No more Amabutho by the Zulus, no regiments. But the first album that Joseph Shabalala decides to name, to give it a name, he calls it Amabutho, which was, again, in-your-face kind of thing. So he was going to have none of this. So his debut album was then dedicated to the Zulu army, basically. The Zulu regiments, Amabutho. The album was produced by one of the most renowned producers, Wu Esinkosi, and it went gold within 3 weeks. Now, it gold was gold then. Today, they've reduced it goes to 15,000 units. When gold was like 25,000. Now they see what I say. Platinum was 50, now platinum is 20. They did gold within 3 weeks. And again, and to remind the world who they were, that's why they call themselves Amabutho. Joseph Shabalala's music was definitely music of defiance. That's what it means. It is non-conformist. It refuses to be undermined, nor to be glorified. But because it was never created for glorification, no validation. This music has existed and survived by telling village stories of loved ones left behind, stories of harvest, imigido, stories of triumph in the midst of adversity, and occasionally dabbling into politics, as was evident in some of Joseph Shabalala's compositions, such as the lyrics from the song Halala, South Africa, where he opens with a cry about the plight of blacks in our country. And I want you to listen carefully to that song, just a few seconds, and what it says. It's called Halala, South Africa. Listen to what he's saying. Pagamis.
Sage, sagu, sagu bele, tatna.
Sage,
sagu tuala matu.
Sage,
sagu bona, sagu bele,
tatna.
Womnya, mumai katel, womnya mabu.
Womnya, mumai katel, womnya.
Kotum katelela, numtanga bantu.
Womnya, mumai.
Matin Bafan.
Good boy, carry on. Good boy, good boy, carry on.
Nang umsoop and I say Castellumia Mabu.
Womsoopma, the Castellumia.
What to Castellan by am Sanganet?
Womsoopma, the Castellumia.
Matin Bafan.
Well done, well done. You did a good job, you did a good job, properly performed. Well done, well done. Sure. Carry on.
Nice.
Yo. So, just for translation, those who didn't understand, Shabalala composes a song, but it's got hidden transcripts, because when you read it, it says Halala, South Africa. It's congratulations, South Africa. But his very few first lyrical messages. He says, when a black person is hitting a black person, they say, carry on, you know? When he says they say, he's not talking about blacks. He says, Abelung, the whites, I say, yeah, let them kill each other. And then when a white person kicks a black person, they say, good job, well done, perfectly performed, you know? But the song is, says Halala South. It's just reminding us of where we come from and the circumstances under which we find ourselves. So had it not been for the creative work and commitment to this genre by the likes of Joseph Shabalala, whose group Ladysmith Black Mambazo has gone to become global icons and cultural ambassadors and winning multiple Grammy Awards, this music would have still remained in the shadows and corridors of men's hostels and at backyard servants' quarters in white suburbs. Those who know how the history of this music and why it is called Ungumamsugu and why it is called Gotova is because back then, when this music came about, blacks were secluded to a particular compound, a particular place in a city, and they were not allowed to be anywhere else other than where they are supposed to be. Wake up in the morning, go to work, and come back, go to the compounds. So at night when they are tired and they now remember home, that collective memory we're talking about in Nduduzo, and they dig deep into their soul, into their culture and tradition, they remember the songs that they sing in the weddings, but they perform them in the middle of the night and they don't want to be detected by the powers that be because they're not even supposed to be doing that. So this Xhosa, they call it Isicathamiya Xhosa, tiptoeing, is they're doing all the steps, they're doing all the Zulu dance that you could do, but you can't hear it because they're not supposed to make noise. That is where it comes from. Now, Joseph was a very humble person. This is when Omoya, and he didn't have to know you to make you feel important. It was as if he already knows you, you know? I mean, I don't remember even introducing myself properly to Ubab Joseph, but suddenly we just had this connection. And I remember a few instances which I'll just quickly touch on. One day I'm on the flight from Durban to Johannesburg, and I happen to sit in the same seat as him. So he sees me walking through. I've got sinuses and very irritable left nostril, so I'm always doing this. So he sees me, and because I'm in Durban, there's humidity. My sinuses then and hay fever, they just become, you know, enhanced. So I go there, I walk into the aircraft, already feeling like that. Then he says to me, hey, you know, Sithole, don't do this in public because people will think you are sniffing cocaine. That's what he said. Just like that. And since then, I have been very careful. I carry a handkerchief because I really have serious sinuses. And I am always careful. So rather than doing this, I use the handkerchief because Joseph Shaba told me not to do this thing in public. But there was also one instance when I was a group MD, deputy MD at Gallo Records. We get a call from his manager, Mitch. He's a global manager, US manager, says, Mambazo is in London. There is a movie of starring Sean Connery, and it's called The League of Extraordinary Gentlemen. And Hollywood has called us, they want Mambazo to do a song, a soundtrack of the song of the movie. And we are going to studio now. We said, you are going to studio? Yeah, Mitch. Mambazo is signed to ladies to Gallo Records. Our job is to protect their rights, their intellectual property, composition, and otherwise. There is no way that Mambazo is going to go into a studio and do a song, a blockbuster, a soundtrack to a movie called The League of Extraordinary Gentlemen without a contract. He says, no, but the guys are ready. They've been practicing. They are ready to go. We said, Mitch, it's not going to happen. Tell them to call us, whoever those people, so that you can have a contract. Because we are asking a simple question. How much are the royalties for this soundtrack? Who controls the composition? Who's going to publish the composition? Is the film going to be in cinemas? Is it going to be on television? Is it going to be released on DVD, on CD, or DVD, sorry? Or is it going to be a soundtrack compilation? Are there going to be related royalties out of all the exploitation of what you've told us? Then he says, no, you know what? Then he says, you'll call us back. Then he comes back, he says, the Hollywood directors are saying if we don't want to, they're going to, there's a group in London, they do Isicathamiya, I don't remember their name now, Mfolos or something. Yeah, Mfolos, yeah. They're going to get Mfolos to go and record. I said, go get Mfolos. In the meantime, we're going to prepare an agreement for you of what we think this Hollywood company must sign. 2 weeks later, we signed the contract. And Bab Shabalala comes back to South Africa and says, he was always willing to learn, said, thank you so much. Because the manager gets will invoice for their time in studio. That's not our money. It's for their time in studio, and he will give them whatever he takes his commission. But the future royalties of this film, which is still there today, is still generating income for this group and for the generations and generations to come. I was in studio when they did When You Girl, Raise Your Spirit High. I remember going to downtown studios. By the way, Richard Mitchell passed away, I think. He passed away the other day. That's the engineer that used to record Mambazo. When I went to Gallo, after listening to the song, I was like, they've got a hit. But what do you? I said, I've only heard one song, but it's a hit album. That album got, this was the second Grammy Award of Joseph. I got to work with him also when we were doing Friends in Concert, when we, Jabu Kanyile and Lucky Dube were collaborating, singing each other's songs. Shabalala was going to sing Malowe, and all. I was the producer of that. But there was one part that really touched me when he lost his notebook full of his compositions in Cape Town. We were promoting When You Girl. The notebook is gone. He carried this notebook because, I mean, he dreams Mam Shabalala too. Then he writes, he wakes up and he writes something. Dreams, then he wakes up and he writes. So this notebook was full of his composition. He lost it. We searched for the entire waterfront in Cape Town. We couldn't find it, you know, and I remember that. So just to get back, so Joseph then finds himself in an urban setting that sought to exclude Africans, and soon engage in musical practice in order to rearrange their space and existence in the city. They rearranged their space and existence in a city that did not want them. That's what Shabalala did. Isicathamiya, therefore, emerges out of a feeling of displacement and alienation of village migrants who find themselves in an urban setting that was only designed as a place of work. No singing, no kotoze. Joseph Shabalala and his defining music is testimony of how, after being treated as an urban outcast, because they were urban outcasts, they used the dark of the night to artistically break down social barriers in order to find a voice and again recognition as voices from the margins at daybreak. So you wake up in the morning, there's this big sound, this big genre. It was crafted in the middle of the night in complete silence. Then there was Isicathamiya. So he showed that even inside these confined and segregated spaces, a cultural phenomenon could be crafted, albeit in the middle of the night. It was the slow dance movement and light footsteps which became known as ukuthokoza, to tiptoe, hence the name Isicathamiya. Stealing time and space inside the servants' quarters when employers were asleep, these a cappella groups rehearsed songs and practice and choreograph dance movements, which they call istebu. And I'm always amazed by how they lift their legs, like, just easily, you know. So these synchronized footsteps had to be practiced in complete silence so as not to make noise that would wake up neighbors or those sleeping in the main house, afraid of being detected even by the slightest noise from stamping on the floor. They tiptoed and in four-part harmony, melodically sang, albeit in whispering voices, some of the coveted songs their country will be remembered. Joseph dedicates a song to mine workers that were toiling underground, and they would emerge from the underground and they would be locked in the compounds. And then he does a song called Nansi Mali. I know what DJ will say a corner. Nansi Mali, Elandezi Tima. Elandezi.
Nansi Mali, Nansi Mali, Elandezi Nsizwa Phantsi Emgodini. Imali. Sase saibone mali, elanda sinsizwa le kude. La unge kufike kuna wena, ngobu no falo, panse mkotini. We sinsizwa, sinsizwa zagiti siyan halalisela. Mamandla nange sibindi, ngobu snigela kwenu.
Vale.
We sinsizwa.
Yeah. I mean, if you read history and the discovery of gold and diamond in Joburg and Kimberley, you would learn that they had to go to the villages to get the Africans because they were brave and strong. They tried the Chinese. They were not strong enough with respect to them. They tried the Indians. They were not strong enough. And that systematic extraction of Africans from the villages through the imposition of poll tax and hard tax and dog tax and marriage tax, had to force some of them to go and work because that tax was wanted by government. So that's why they ended up working in the mines. And he dedicates this song to the mine workers. So when the colonialists and mine bosses, the police who police the movement of blacks in the city, woke up to this music, and it had taken over the city. Isicathamiya had taken over the city. Its practitioners showed the repressive system the middle finger. And they said, if you thought we would remain just perpetual migrant workers toiling in the mines or wherever and sulking in the compounds and back at Seven Quarters, forget about it. We are going to reimagine. Remember the quote by Newman that creative and adaptive people facing exploitation, and they will make meaning of their own world and create something. That is what Shabalala and them did. So it was the creative expression of a people like Joseph Shabalala, who after finding themselves trapped in the city, that would rather pretend they did not exist, except as general workers. They sought to find meaning to this new world by creatively and artistically delving deep into hidden memories of life left back in the villages. And Isicathamiya became their response through which cultural and social barriers of exclusion, alienation, and exploitation were confronted. We are talking here about the recipient of the Order of Ikhamanga in gold, a cultural preservationist, the protector of indigenous arts, whose group, Ladysmith Black Mambazo, has gone to win 5 Grammys, and they refused to be farm laborers or general workers in the city for meager wages. He escaped labor tenancy on the farms and harsh working conditions in the city, and he created his own firm. I think it was Leicester who spoke about what they've created, or was it the VC? He created his own firm, this company called Ladysmith Black Mambazo, that has employed and fed many families and even employed white people like Mitch in the US. It's a company. This is what Joseph Shabalala created. He was no longer employed by anybody. Now, his group then gets chosen to perform at the reception of the Nobel Peace Prize in Norway. It's chosen by Nelson Mandela. It was not out of just sheer coincidence and that they sing nice and all of that. What we didn't know is that the late Professor Joseph Shabalala was actively involved, albeit covertly, in the struggle for liberation in this country. He was raising funds for both the ANC and the PAC, working with Makatini Ndwedwe and Oliver Tambo. He even donated 288 suits to the leadership in the 90s. And I was even wondering when I thought, these suits, 288, I'm trying to count, how many 288 leaders? Then I remember Taiman. I remember Gwede Mantashe wearing an oversized. Yeah, you remember? Yeah. I'm like, and I asked myself, could Gwede have inherited? whether he had inherited one of the unallocated Kotwa Gwede. Because, I mean, you remember he's got. He's a Kishi Figela. Yeah, man, that's 288 suits. One of them went to Gwede Mantashe. And there's another story. No, but he must tell us where he got this suit. The Minister of Energy and Mineral Affairs. Another story is told that Joseph Shabalala used to send Ladysmith Black Mambazo cassettes via Winnie Mandela to Robben Island Prison, because some of those political prisoners had been so inspired by the music of Joseph Shabalala, and they needed to master the art. So those cassettes that Winnie Mandela was when he went to visit Nelson Mandela, he would then take them with him. So when he released the album Long Walk to Freedom in 2006, which also received 2 Grammy nominations, it definitely had been a long journey for Joseph Shabalala. From that New Year's Eve in 1959, it had been a long journey. Joseph Shabalala loved his music. He loved the genre Isicathamiya. He even wrote a song about it, urging the musicians to develop, preserve, and promote this music to greater heights. So if you hear this song in Ndlondlobala Njalo, just listen to what he's saying. I'll translate Professor Rose and the other professors there. What is he saying about this genre? DJ.
Ukhulu khule njalo wena
sizwa abantu bethi thina besethu sizwa ndomkhulu
dlondlo
bala njalo mculo wasekhaya
hayibo
bamukele
bonke
abazobona
khulu
mkhulu mculo
khulu ngempela.
He's talking about how big this genre is and how important it is for this genre to even grow beyond its growth today. And that those practitioners who embrace, those artists that I listed in my opening acknowledgement, how important it is for them to continue. So as I close, I don't know how many of you know the full names of Joseph Shabalala. One of his names is Uspati Mandla. And he lived up to that. He was now his own boss. Yenobe Peter Mandla, Tubano Petela, Joseph Shabalala. That's the man. Yeah. He, and as a leader of this group, Ubepete, and Amanda Onke. So if someone, as I said, asks who's the leader of the group, Wanopet, they would point out to him. There's only one name that I am particularly not happy about, Nkosinathi. Mxoveni. Yeah. I'm not happy about this name. Because his names were Joseph, Bhekizizwe, Siphathimandla, Mxoveni, Big Boy Shabalala. Now, Mxoveni is a name that has got, I don't know how it came about, because it has got nothing to do with the character of the individual. I don't even want to explain it. And I think we need to go to Home Affairs and posthumously remove this name, because he doesn't deserve it. That's not him. Yeah. Inomland, umkhulu. How? So one day we'll hear. So, but finally, I want to say, shame on you, colonialism. You didn't win. Joseph Bhekizizwe Siphathimandla Mxoveni Big Boy Shabalala beat you to the finishing line. He win, his group won 5 Grammys. 1998, Shaka Zulu. 2005, Raise Your Spirits High, which is the same album that we released in South Africa as When You Get. 2009, Ilembe. Again, Ilembe, Elekamanya Malem or Kalipa. That is the praise songs of Shaka Zulu. And then 2014, Live Singing for Peace. And then 2018, Shaka Zulu Revisited. That is the work of Joseph Shabalala. And I want to thank you so much for allowing me to pen this and talk about this great young man. This was a young man, and he grew up to be this icon that we respect him to be. And thank you. I thank you.
Wow. There's nothing that one can add on what Dr. Sithole has just fed us with. And I want to say, there could not have been any better person to deliver this inaugural lecture. And thanks to the collective wisdom that you guys shared a common idea that there could be nobody else but Dr. Sithole. Thank you so much for that to the working team. So many new things. An inspiration, and many of us will be going home with all this treasure. But I've got only one request. Dr. Sithole, that paper you are not going home with. Beautiful. Thank you so much. And the bar has been set up now high. This means it's a challenge to the organizing committee now. We should start dreaming about who will be the next for 2022. Otherwise, we can't lower the bar. Had it not been for it being televised, we would have said we can take anyone. But unfortunately, South Africa has tasted this inaugural quality lecture. And we say to Dr. Sithole, thank you so much. Thank you so much. In everything that you said, to me, it's centered around one thing, which has been penned by Elrod, by Hall Elrod in his book, Triumph Over Adversity.
where, as I quote him, when you live your life in alignment with a purpose that is centered on selflessly adding value for others, opportunities become abundant and your life becomes fulfilled, unquote. He refused and triumphed over adversity. Thank you once more. And to Prof Shabalala, wherever he is, we will continue to salute him. As you said, he is not only your hero, but ours too. Thank you once more. Now, coming back to our program, with powers vested in me, you know, it's good when you're a program director. Even those that are your principals become your subjects. With powers vested in me, Deputy Vice Chancellor, Teaching and Learning, Professor Vital, can you please come forward? As I kindly request you to present this present to Dr. Sithole. And Dr. Sithole, can we kindly ask you to please come forward as the cameras and everybody catches the moment. Thank you very much, Professor Vital. Now, there is a change in the program. There is no way that after such a scintillating presentation by Dr. Sithole, we cannot look. I am salivating here, and I cannot afford not to request Ladysmith Black Mambazo to take the stage. And as you were busy, Dr. Sithole, you're talking about 1964, Bob Mazibuko was 18 years old, and I look at this man now, I said, my goodness, I looked older than him now. He looks so young. When in 1964, he was 18 years. Look at him now. It's amazing. Khona izinto angazityiyo. And as Ladysmith Black Mambazo will be giving us some beautiful music, I will kindly request Professor Buhlungu, together with Ubaba Sithole, after Behlile on the stage. Ubaba Sithole, as the group will be bowing down to take their seats, Ubaba Sithole will be going to join the Vice Chancellor there for the signing of the MOU and all cameras. That's another moment that will be caught for South Africa to witness that, yes, a relationship officially exists. Ladies and gentlemen, can we welcome Ladysmith Black Mambazo back on stage, please?
In 1985, Ladysmith Black Mambazo met with a gentleman by the name of Paul Simon, and together we wrote a song, Homeless. Homeless is a song of awareness that people are suffering. They sleep in the cliffs, they sleep in the shelters, they have no homes. Poverty is still all around the world. We should take care of one another. We are homeless. Emaweni we baba silale maweni we baba silale maweni we baba silale maweni
Homeless.
sleeping on a midnight lake.
And we are homeless,
we are homeless. Moonlight sleeping on a midnight lake.
And we are homeless,
we are homeless. Moonlight sleeping on a midnight lake.
And we are
homeless,
homeless,
homeless.
Boom, boom.
Moonlight sleeping on a midnight lake.
Strong winds,
strong
wind, destroy our homes.
Many dead tonight could be.
Strong winds,
strong
wind,
strong wind. Many dead tonight could be.
And we are
homeless,
homeless,
homeless.
Boom, boom.
Moonlight sleeping on the midnight
lake.
Homeless,
homeless,
homeless.
Boom, boom.
Moonlight sleeping on the midnight lake. We homeless,
we homeless.
Moonlight sleeping on a midnight lake.
Somebody sing. Somebody sing.
Hello, hello, hello.
Somebody sing. Somebody cry.
Why, why, why?
Somebody sing. Somebody sing.
Hello, hello, hello.
Somebody say. Somebody cry.
Why, why, why?
Somebody sing.
Ito mango. Ito mango. Isango bonongilizwe. Ito mango. Ito mango.
Somebody sing. Somebody sing.
Hello, hello, hello.
Somebody say. Somebody cry.
Why, why, why?
Somebody sing. Somebody sing.
Hello, hello, hello.
Somebody say. Somebody cry.
Why, why, why?
Kulumani.
Kuluman. Kulumani says.
Singen, Zijan.
Baya chabula basitanda. Yo, wo.
Sebo. Iculi landilayo solicula lithi lelungelo elakho. Isikhathi esiningi uma sicula leli culo khona la kufika khona kuthiwa isiqumqum sikababa, isiqumqum sikamama. Makhulunywa ngesiqumqum sikamama ngeke ngicabanga umama ke ngiyaye ngikhombe yena uma yekhona ngithi isiqumqum sikamama. Ngoba uyena okwazile ukuthi awuhlanganisa umndeni kuze kube yimanje. Aphinde futhi uyena owayesibhekela ubaba engasaphathekile kahle. Wayibamba impela kwase kwafika egcineni soke siyambonga kakhulu. Silithola ithuba lokuthi simbonge. Kodwa ke namhlanje ngithi angilithathe nje simbonge umama wethu umsebenzi wakhe omuhle awenzayo. Isikhathi esiningi komama ngisho kuthiwa kuyahanjwa ekhaya. Kuyayithiwa hey, umama usebambezele kodwa umama yini? Sikhohle ukuthi umama yena uvuke singakavuki. Wapheka, wasilungisela, wa-ayinela ubaba wenza zonke izinto. Before kuhanjwe bese kuthi mangabe sekufanele ayilungise yena bese sithi uyasibambezela so kufuneka sikubheke lokho madoda singakwenzi lokho omama yibona bas abenza umsebenzi omningi ngaphezulu kwethu siyabonga
umuntu ongazi ucabanga ukuthi uyazi antakazilu thowaziyo
uvela nze kwenzeke
lilungelunge lakho mngana
lelo lungelunge
lakho mngana nami
What a moment. I bet you can cover the Vice Chancellor work on his hands a bit. Vice Chancellor, this is come senses. Dr. Albert Mazibuko, together with the Vice Chancellor, can you please? Dr. Mazibuko on the left hand side and the Vice Chancellor on the right hand side. And the camera people, please be on standby to catch the moment. Can you get the background of whatever Ladysmith Black Mambazo song, please, whilst the signing ceremony is going on?
Foreign, 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 beautiful rain,
beautiful rain,
don't disturb,
don't disturb,
beautiful rain,
beautiful rain,
oh come, never come, oh come. Never come, oh, come to me, beautiful rain. Oh, come, never come, oh, come, never come, oh, come to me, beautiful rain.
Rain,
rain, rain, rain, rain, beautiful rain. Rain, 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 beautiful rain. Oh, come, never come, oh, come. Never come, oh, come to me, beautiful rain. Oh, come, never come, oh, come, never come, oh, come to me, beautiful rain.
When the
sun says goodnight to the mountain,
Subasasuka Vice Chancellor, Subasasuka Visi, no Dr. Mazibuko, can you ask the entire group, the Mambazo group, to come just behind?
To the mountain
them.
After sun, said goodnight.
Yeah, let's remove the table. The Mambazo group behind you, VC, Notatu Mazibuko, the entire group.
Umbigo wozalwa kwenkosi Jesu, nazo inkanyezi, enhle ngaso
zonke. Baba, Baba wame,
Baba,
Baba wame,
Peshulako.
Okay, don't move, Doctor.
Isel, Inkosi amakhosi.
Mama,
Dr. Sithole and Dr. Koyana. Can you go and join them, please? Dr. Koyana, get between Vice Chancellor and Bob Mazibuko. Thank you. Please remain. Dr. Koyana and Dr. Sithole can sit down. Mama U Shabalala. Sesukela ma. Uba join. Yeah, it's coming. Mama Shabalala, pagatu kwa visi no babu umasibuko. Bamba chose. Ozala. Imi no pete la mfetu. Let's wait for Obama Josie. Obama
Josie.
Yana ngapagat.
Kilinyelanga. Kilinyelanga basumbona.
Pigger, my daughter,
Mamu Shabalala ngahlala phansi ubaba Sithole umajosi ba majosi ngahlala phansi ucela all the members the MEC members to go and join Professor Vital, Dr. Van Yerden, Mr. Zuma. Thank you very much. Thank you so much. Thank you so much, Professor Vital, for the vote of thanks. Thank you. Can you sit down and be settled?
Wow, what a morning. I just want to say, wow, what a morning. When the Vice Chancellor said we have an inaugural memorial lecture and an MOA to sign, it was just like one of those normal days, work to be done. But this has been such a treat. It's just been fantastic. And I feel like normally you can't wait for these events to end, but today I could stay. So I just want to first of all start off by saying on behalf of the University of Fort Hare, we are deeply honored and grateful to formalize this partnership through this inaugural lecture in the name of an amazing, great music icon and phenomenon, Professor Joseph Shabalala. It is just really something that as a university we will cherish greatly. So I do want to thank then, as we bring this event to a close, the presence of our Deputy Chair of Council, Dr. Koyana, thank you for being here. The Vice Chancellor, Professor Bushlungu, you are not gonna live down this event. We saw you sing and dance. We didn't know that was part of your competences, but it was something really that I think we will remember for a long time. I want to thank members of MEC who are here, as well as the Dean, Professor Ruiz, of the Faculty of Humanities and Social Sciences. And then most of all, I do want to thank the family, of the Shabalala family, and especially Mrs. Shabalala, thank you for being here with us. And also Mr. Nkosinathi Shabalala, thank you for your presentation as well. And then there's this amazing guest lecture we had today, our inaugural lecture and guest speaker, Dr. Sithole. What a wonderful talk. I was just so engrossed. It was amazing in how you put your lecture together that brought together a history of music, of music now, of politics, of sociology, of so many different disciplines in the talk, and yet you delivered it in a way that enriched us all greatly. And I look forward to reading the lecture again. So thank you very much for that wonderful presentation. I do want to thank our head of department and the music department from the university, Mr. Macatini. We know you are our jazz maestro and multi-awards winner. Thank you very much for all the work you've done in bringing this event here and putting it to participating in the process of putting it together. And then also to another member of our staff and head of department, Dr. Potelwa, who's also here on behalf of the National Arts Council Visual Arts as a panel member of that council. Thank you very much. And then I do want to thank the Ladysmith Black Mambazo Foundation Manager, Mr. Majozi, and the board members present here, including Mr. Albert Mazibuko. Thank you very much for your presentation and also for your presence and being part of this amazing event today. And then, of course, the absolute treat for all of us to have this amazing Black Mambazo, Ladysmith Black Mambazo group, multiple awards winners, 5 Grammys, and to be here on this Saturday morning and hear you, what a treat. Thank you so much. Thank you. I also want to take this opportunity to thank all the media houses. We're very happy that the event has gotten the kind of coverage that it has. And then finally, to thank the university's institutional advancement. Thank you, Program Director, for leading us, Mr. Pitti, through the event today. And then all the members of the institutional advancement, too many to mention, but all of you who have put together this wonderful event, thank you very much for all the work that was done. And then finally, as a Deputy Vice Chancellor for Teaching and Learning, I'm so excited by the event today, and in particular our signing of this MOA, and the possibility that the university will into the future be able to offer programs that will recruit young minds, young musicians, young scholars to come to the university to study and learn about these great icons, I think, like we've had today in this lecture. We want to be able to offer programs where our students will come to the University of Fort Hare as this amazing institution to be able to study and read and actually work with materials, original materials, that no other university in the country or in the world would be able to offer, and to really grow that scholarship so that the generations to come will remember and learn and carry these legacies forward. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Professor Vital, and let me also thank you for thanking me. And hopefully somebody else would come and thank me for having thanked you. Yeah. What a day. What a day. I don't think I could have received any better Christmas present than this. It's a wonderful moment, a highlight in one's life, a highlight for our university. Just an amazing moment. And as we conclude our program, we want to thank you all for having graced this occasion and having joined millions and millions of South Africans who have viewed it from home. And want to say, please, may we be safe as we have started this journey. The virus is so vicious out there. Let's try to be as safe as we can be and try to protect those that we live and love at home. Those that have not vaccinated, please do so. It's the wise thing to do. And as we conclude our program, we will honestly be entertained. The Vice Chancellor has spent some few cents to make sure that we enjoy lunch. We are all invited to enjoy lunch, but how we are going to do it is we are going to allow these three tables together with the Ladysmith Black Mambazo to go out and dish for themselves. It's a self-service. After they are back, then we will give instructions as to who else would be. With those wonderful words, we want to say, it has been a pleasure to be with you. May your gods bless and protect you, and have a lovely Merry Christmas and a prosperous New Year. Thank you.